Hello everyone, welcome to the Learn Biology Online. Today we are gonna discuss about our next topic, that is classification of enzymes. So we can classify the enzyme on the basis of the type of the reaction that has occurring and the reaction catalyzed by an enzyme. So enzyme catalyze different reactions. So on the basis of these catalyzing power, we can classify the enzymes, and we are classifying them into six classes. Okay. So I have written the first letter of these enzyme of these classes, like O, T, H. So you can remember easily. So O, T, H, remember this by oath. Okay. And next is little. Oath, little. Okay. O stands for oxidoreductase, and T is for transferase, and H is for hydrolases. L stands for lyases, and next I stands for isomerases. And last class, which is L, is stand for ligases. Now let's discuss. First is oxidoreductase. This class basically include all those enzymes which is either working as an oxidation process or occurring in a reduction process. So those enzymes which are responsible for either oxidation or reduction, we included them in an oxidoreductase class. Now, example like oxidases, they are usually which use oxygen as an electron acceptor. Dehydrogenases, which use a molecule other than O2, like NAD positive is used as an electron acceptor. So you know that in number of chemical reactions, this NAD positive undergo dehydrogenase process to reduce into NADH plus H positive. Now this H positive is removing. So this is a dehydrogenase process. Next is oxygenase. Oxygenase means which directly incorporate oxygen into the substrate. Next is peroxidases. Peroxidases also included in this class. Why? Because they are using a H2O2 as an electron acceptor. Second class is transferases. You can easily have an idea about the transferases. Why? Because they are basically transferring one group from the substrate to the product. So these are the very simple processes, like methyl transferases. They used to transfer methyl group. From the initial word, we can determine what they are transferring. Okay, amino transferase, that means they are transferring amino group. Kinases are those which transfer the phosphate group from ATP to the substrate. So as we know, in the glycolysis, in the first step, when this glucose is converted into the glucose 6-phosphate with the help of hexokinase, and this hexokinase using the phosphate group from the ATP, and then they are forming a glucose 6-phosphate. So kinases are responsible for transferring a phosphate group. While this phosphorylases is transfer the phosphate group from inorganic phosphate to the substrate. Okay. Next is hydrolases. Hydro means water. So in the presence of water, when something is break down, then we call them hydrolases. Now in this class, you can see this is an A plus B, and the water, if we put water into this, this will lead to breakdown of these substrate and form a product like this. Okay, example like phosphatases. Proteases also, which break down the amino acid bond, and this is because of the presence of water. Phosphodiesterases. Okay, so next is lyases. Now understand this. What is lyases? Lyase is basically the addition of groups to the double bond, or the formation of double bond by removal of group. So I hope you will study in a, so basically in the chemistry, you see that is there is a number of reaction which is having a groups. This is the X and this is Y. Just remember these are the halogens. Now, if we remove this, they will form a double bond. Why? To complete their covalency. To complete their valency, they need to form a double bond, and they will form another product. So lyases are those which basically addition of groups or the removal of groups. They either can form double bond or they form a single bond by removal. Okay, these are the lysates which normally use in the biology. Example like decarboxylases. Decarboxylase, they produce a CO2. Decarboxylases means removal of CO2 that lead to formation of a double bond. Okay, aldolases. So remember this aldolase example when in the glycolysis, when this 2,6-bisphosphate will convert into a two product, that is DHAP and 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. So in this aldose is used. Why? Because they're responsible to eliminating the reaction, you know, to break the bond between the 6 carbon molecules and form a 2 substrate molecules. And this is synthesis. They also link the 2 molecules without the involvement of ATP. So ATP is not utilized in the reaction. Next is isomerases. In the isomerases, so isomers are those molecules which are having a same formula but different, you know, conformation. So AB is changed into BA. As you know, these are having a same type of structures. You know, A and B are both are same, and here B and A is also same to the A and B, but their conformation is changed. You know, you can see the AB having this orientation and this B is having this orientation. So mutase is enzyme. It transfers the group between atoms within a molecule to create an isomeric form. It's a same example in the glycolysis, you know. Next is ligases. Now in the ligases, ATP is used to form any bond between two molecules. We require ATP, while in lyases, we do not require ATP. Okay. So A plus B is added with the help of AT to form this bond, and this ADP will remove out. Energy required to ligate. So you know, in the DNA replication, you know, when there's a nick are formed, we used to ligate them. So we use their ligases, which basically require an ATP. Okay. So I think this is it for today, and I hope you like the video. If you like it, please subscribe it. Thank you so much.